Well, hello everyone. Today I'm going to do something very special, something new, since I've never done any YouTube gaming videos until today. But I'm recording this video because I'm playing a game called Ark Survival Evolved, and I have seen many bases being built, and I already mentioned on a few videos that I'm also building a little base on this server, which looks a bit like a South American pyramid, an Aztec pyramid actually. And people have been very curious as to how it looks, so I thought I might show you a little bit. It's a work in progress, not finished yet, but I can show you a little bit how it looks like. So first of all, you might notice that this isn't a default Ark map. It's we play on a server which runs the Valhalla map, which is a custom map for Ark Survival Evolved, and it looks pretty damn amazing. It's not yet finished, but it looks awesome. So this is here my little starting cabin, starting hut, where I have all my storage and crafting facilities in order to build things, store some meat, store some vegetables, anything. But this isn't what I wanted to show you. The thing I wanted to show you is this work in progress. It's this little Aztec pyramid. Well, little, it's turning out to be a little bit big. It's my third attempt at building something with this kind of architecture. The first time, well, it looked ugly, was on an official server, Ark server. The second time, it looked pretty decent, pretty darn good. It was even a little bit bigger than this version. But once I started upgrading it to stone, the server, well, sadly disappeared, and it's gone. So all my work is gone. So now I'm playing on this server here. It's a PvP kind of server, role-playing server, and I started to build this Aztec pyramid here. So this is still work in progress. It's only the first two levels of the pyramid which are ready. I think I will be adding two or three more, two levels and two more levels like this, and then one top building, so three levels actually. It's pretty big. Well, every side, let's go up this level. The base level is actually started out as being 40 blocks, a square of 40 blocks, so each side is 40 blocks. But from there on, I expanded with these sloped corners. Actually, it's not really corners, sloped sides, so that's another 10, 10 blocks out. And as you can see, it's 12 blocks high. Why did I need 12 blocks high? Well, because I wanted to fit in a behemoth gate, so I can put my dinosaurs inside and go out with my dinosaurs. I've decided to have this approach on every side except this side here. This side is just simply the wall. I didn't expand it from here because I had too much forest I had to go get rid of, and I really liked it. The scenery looked a little bit better, and it would have been a little bit more, well, uglier for me. So I decided to leave that side just like that. But every other side has this layout. I have one side which oh, let's go grab some food before I die. I'm starving at the moment, so I know I have some food in my preserving bins, so let's go grab that. There, five should be good. Okay, eat a bit, and let's continue with the showcase. So this side here borders to the water. I thought it would just touch the shores, but apparently I did some miscalculations. And as you can see, I had to mess here a little bit with pillars and ceilings instead of foundations. But hey, it was just too deep here. But as you can see again, the behemoth gate with the two sloped sides, and same thing on this side. You see, this is one of the other entrances, so three entrances. Everyone has its behemoth gates. As you can see, I had to put a little sign up stating that I was going to build something big here, so other people wouldn't build right next to it, and they didn't, so which is nice. So every consequent level is a little bit smaller than the base level, so five blocks smaller, and again with on every side some sloped sides, and this time there are only four blocks tall, and I added in a normal dinosaur gate, a stone dinosaur gate. But here I decided to go with the same approach for every side, even this little side here. Let's go up, and from here on I will be adding two more levels, which will be a little bit smaller again. As you can see, in the bottom I have already a lot of stone foundations. I was quite lucky that this location is pretty flat, so I could build almost everything with stone foundations, except some corners, some of these sloped sides. I had to go fiddle with ceilings and pillars instead. But as you can see, 40 blocks by 40 blocks, that's 1,600 stone foundations, which is a lot of stone and a lot of thatch and a lot of wood. So I'm still collecting the materials to finish it up. I only did go that far yet, because then I could add the second level due to it. But as you can see, I now have to add another row of stone foundations, otherwise I will not be able to build the next level. Let's go inside now, have a look inside. This is still pretty much a work in progress, as you can see. I'm still not done with the layout. Well, the layout is done, but I mean with the decoration. Decoration will be at the end. Let's close this gate. But as you can see from the inside, it looks pretty symmetric. And I have these sloped sides, as I call them, which give me some additional room to do a few things. I'm thinking about using this one, for example, for a cooking area with storage for cooking recipes and finished cooking products. Why? Because, well, under here I have access to some water. Under these foundations there is some water, so I can put a water intake and maybe have some cooking stuff here. Then I'm thinking about using the others for crafting. For example, this side could be the crafting area with the forges and the fabricator and an industrial forge. Maybe I can continue that on this side here. Maybe in the middle I will add some more things, I'm not quite sure what. But as you can see, I didn't close up every level yet, because, well, I just can't for now. There are no stone foundations enough. I would have to close everything up with stone foundations first. But I wanted to finish the outside first and then think about the inside. Every level will have its stone dinosaur gate, and again two sloped sides and a little square corner. And I'm planning on adding some ramps or similar things to go from one level to the other level to the other level. On this side, I already mentioned this is 40 blocks wide and 12 blocks tall, but I'm planning on separating and adding an in-between level, as you can see at the sixth stone wall. I already added the ceiling, and I'm planning to expand that all the way up there, and maybe five blocks wide of the or deep in this case, and have some dinosaur pens up there, so I can store some smaller dinosaurs up there. Oh, let's go grab the trike egg. I'm not quite sure if I will do it, because there is on this server there is a limit on the number of dinosaurs you can have for performance reasons. Oh, it's the egg I want. Well, probably lag. Yeah, lag. I will get it soon. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, the dinosaur pens. So I'm thinking about adding them, but then again, if there is a dinosaur limit of 18 dinosaurs, maybe I won't need the dinosaur pens. Will I need, well, the additional levels? Maybe if I find some tribe members, then we can share the building. Maybe a good idea also to have a look from above, because, well, it gives a better view. Let's take this Terra and fly out. Let's first raise to the top a bit. Okay. Just be careful that I don't press the wrong button now, or it would be a deep dive. Let's go into K mode and try to zoom up out as far as I can. There, that's about it. As you see, it's pretty symmetrical. There will be two more levels and a top building. So yeah, I think it will look good. I used the stone sloped stone roofs because I thought it looked a little bit better with some different textures to it. I might change it in the future, not quite sure. I might start to paint it as well, but for now I'm using it like that. Okay, let's try to see how it looks from one side. So there we go. Well, this way it looks a little bit more like a pyramid, and once it will be finished with the two more levels, it will look a little bit better. But as I mentioned before, it requires a lot of materials, and I still have to go collect them because I'm for the time being I'm solo here. I don't have any tribe yet, no people helping me. I decided to go build this first and then go look for a tribe. But for now, well, it looks already pretty good. There is still something to be done about decorations. I'm planning to add things like plant species eggs here on the corners, maybe to for defense on every level. Maybe add some how do they call fences here, so you don't fall off, because it's a pretty big fall. Well, some other things probably as well, but we will have to figure that out once the building is complete. But for now, this is just it. I might record some other videos in the future to show you some updates, maybe some building as well. But that all depends on the feedback I'm getting on this little video. So if you like this video, please by all means press the thumbs up button, share it. Show it to other people. If you have some suggestions on the building process or want to see some other videos, Ark Survival of the Evolved videos, feel free to comment in the comment section, and I will try to respond and maybe incorporate some ideas into the build. But for now, well, this is it. I might be back later on with another video once I have some more building done. But until then, well, I would say, have fun and stay safe. Bye.